Puh. Behind me is a great place to go hunting a Murray cod for a number of reasons. It's relatively slow moving. You'll find cod in our slow moving river pools and our impoundments. You'll also find here a lot of places that cod are going to love to hold, stage and ambush bait fish and other food supply that comes past. You'll find them on overhanging banks and ledges, deeper sections of the river. It's probably 5 to 6 metres deep out here. Great place to find a cod. You'll also find them hanging around some of your midwater boulders. Anywhere there's a little bit of shade, shelter from current, a place then to ambush food, you'll find the Murray cod. In a scenario like this, there's three popular lure choices to use these days. I'm going to show you exactly what they are and how to fish them right now. If you want to go and chase Murray cod in the lure, three lure types you want to have in the tackle box. The very, very versatile spinnerbait, deep diving hard-bodied lure, and the surface lure of some variety. Firstly, the spinnerbait. I've always got these when I'm chasing cod because of their versatility. Come in a number of different sizes, different blade styles, different skirt styles. But what I love about them is vibration. All that flash, rattle and bump that gets put into the water very quickly attracts cod. Once they found your spinnerbait, this is the stuff they're going to eat. Skirt colours, heads, eyes, trailing plastics, all the things which pretty up a spinnerbait, make them very attractive to cod. If I'm fishing with lures like my spinnerbaits or my deep diving hard body lures, this is my preferred outfit. It's a bait cast outfit. Choose a rod of a suitable size to tangle the type of fish you're likely to find. Match it up with a bait cast reel loaded with braided line of a weight which once again is going to suit the type of structure you're fishing and the size of the fish. The reason I love the bait cast, it gives you such direct contact with your lure. Precision casting and really slow retrieves are made very easy with the bait cast. It's the reason we love to use them. Fishing with a spinnerbait and the retrieve you use is about as easy as it gets. Hardest thing I find is casting them. Too many people often land them heavily and spook fish in doing so. What you want to do is find the precise place you want to cast them, get it towards that spot and watch the lure in the air. Just before it lands, get your thumb onto that spool and slow down the speed of the lure. What you'll find is it slides into the water a whole lot easier. And if it suddenly pops up in front of a fish's face, that's most often when you get those reaction bites. Once it's in there, watch your line. Let it get down to the bottom. The moment your line slackens off, it means the spinnerbait's down there. Then don't wind fast. Slow retrieve, 3-4 metres, and then pause. Let it get back down again. You'll be surprised often a fish has come after it, and as it starts fluttering down, they whack it, which means you've got to be watching that line. Keep that same slow retrieve with the odd pause, keeping close to the bottom, all the way back to your feet. You'll be surprised how often cod come and whack a lure just before you pull it out of the water. Thoroughly fish your water, keep moving around until you find fish. You'll be catching cod on spinnerbaits in no time. Deep diving hard body lure is an awesome lure when it comes to targeting Murray cod. It's a favourite among the anglers that want to troll for fish in the impoundments because they let you get down deep. What you want to do, choose one with a bib that has the chosen depth that you love to fish in. If you want to go and fish in those 5 to 8 metre depths, make sure you get a bib that's going to get you down there. And then vary with your profiles and the colours that you choose. For big cod, bigger profiles are a great option. Trolling, obviously walking speed. If you want to troll with these hard body lures, make sure you're bumping the bottom routinely. Casting and retrieving, much like the spinnerbait, get it to where you think the fish are going to be, but then work to get that lure down to the bottom. Work it quickly till you start getting bottom. The moment you start bashing away, you know you're in the zone, and that's when you really slow that retrieve down. Make sure you're continually bumping away, occasionally pausing to let it hang there, but whatever you do, keep it close to bottom, and once again, fish it all the way to your feet. You'll be surprised how often they sneak up and bash it just before you lift it out of the water. And that's how you go about fishing with your deep diving hard-bodied lures. When it comes to fishing your surface lures, there's a huge variety of them on the market these days. What you want to do is work out the most likely surface disturbance you're going to find on a day's cod fishing on the water. You're going to get lizards skidding across the top, or you're going to get insects falling in and splashing and blooping around. That's what you want to imitate. Find a lure which will do that. You've got fizzers, little poppers, splashes, pencil lures which will walk the dog. There's a number of different ways to fish a surface retrieve. Find one that's going to imitate those insects and those lizards, and you're going to get those cod G'd up very, very quickly. This one, beautiful side-to-side action, disturbs the surface of the water, and under a bright moonlit night, there'll be cod lining up to smash this little baby. Gotcha. Woo! That's adrenaline stuff. Nothing like that aggressive bat of a Murray cod coming and belting a lure that you've carefully put into position. And that's the key to catching Murray cod on your lures. Put that lure in the right spot, work it slowly, keep it in front of these fish as long as possible, and you two are going to be getting those bites in no time. See you later.